going through a divorce presents so many challenges and there's so many uncertainties. If you're in the military, I know that that can be even more challenging oftentimes because you don't know what the future holds. Once you get your orders and you know where you're going to be stationed, make sure you share them with your attorney. You and your attorney can then have a meaningful discussion as to the issues in your case and the best way to address those issues. If it's in your best interest and it's not going to be prejudicial to you in any way, you may want to discuss invoking what we call the Service Member Civil Relief Act. It may not be necessary to invoke that act, and we may be able to continue moving your case forward. I think it's going to be important to look at the children's school calendar and make sure we carve out as much time as possible for you to spend with the children. And in my experience, and I'm so grateful to those that serve our country, in my experience, in not super high conflict cases, most of the time, we should all have the unified goal of trying to increase that person's timeshare and give them as much time as possible with the children when they're here, before they leave, on breaks from school. And usually we'll know how long they're going to be gone for so we can carve out time as soon as they return. I also think that, you know, when I have a case where somebody's in the military and the future is unknown, there really are so many advantages to negotiating a parenting plan that's going to require the other parent to give them more flexibility and to give them more leeway and to work with them and to be accommodating. And that's my hope in every case. If it's not, then you should have a meaningful discussion with your attorney and determine what options might be available to you and what the best way to move your case forward is. So if you are if you're in the military and you already have a parenting plan and that court-ordered parenting plan has provisions in place that say in your absence the other parent gets your timeshare, then you would not be able to have someone exercise that timeshare on your behalf. If your agreement is silent to those types of provisions, then arguably your new spouse or a parent, they'd be able to exercise that time on your behalf. Generally speaking, the courts believe that children, that a child, should be with a parent instead of any other third party, even if it is a new spouse, a grandmother, an uncle, an aunt, a family friend. So I absolutely think that a parent not being able to exercise their timeshare or a parent being deployed could be a basis for somebody to bring a modification and seek that additional timeshare that the parent's not able to exercise. But it really would just depend on what's in that parenting plan that's court ordered. If someone doesn't have a parenting plan, well then, generally speaking, that time's gonna go to the other parent. If you're in the military and you're going through a divorce or a paternity or a modification case and you're actively negotiating parenting issues, I think it's crucial that everyone put forth their best efforts to anticipate as many future changes as possible so as to avoid the need for future litigation.